everybody. This is Allie, and welcome to another edition of Ask Allie. Today's question comes from Christine, and Chris asked the most important question, I think, that the universe has ever been asked. How many licks does it take to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? I know! Hasn't that just been driving you crazy? We all want to know. So, I put on some serious, my serious research app for this one, employed every source I could, and I discovered something amazing. Chris, you will never believe what I found.
Of death must answer me these questions three. The other side, he see.
Ask me the questions, Bridgekeeper. I am not afraid.
What is your name?
My name is Sir Lancelot of Camelot.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is your favorite color?
Blue.
Right, off you go.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
Your name?
Sir Galahad of Camelot.
What is your quest?
I seek the Grail.
What is your favorite color?
Blue. No.
Stop. What is your name?
It is Arthur, King of the Britons.
What is your quest?
To seek the Holy Grail.
What is the number of licks it takes to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop? What do you mean? A chocolate or a blueberry Tootsie Pop?
I don't know that.
Well, you have to know these things when you're a king, you know.
How many licks did you usually find it took to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop to help the nation solve this mystery? I've tested most of them again and with great appreciation for all the flavors.
What specifically, I'm curious that you...
All of them, any of them that have been in front of me over all these years. I have a vast variety of sources.
Where we get our pops.
Alaska isn't a foreign country where it's kind of suggested, it seems like, wow, how could you keep in touch with what the rest of Washington, D.C. may be thinking and doing when you live up there in Alaska? Believe me, Alaska is like a microcosm of America.
And there you have it, folks. A mystery for the ages. How many licks it takes to get to the center of a Tootsie Pop. We may never know. You can visit Chris's blog at christinebryant.blogspot.com. I hope you go check her out. She does some amazing things on her blog. She has tag-along Tuesdays on which she scours the interwebs for the best quotes and information she can find and links it all up there for you. Super cool. And then on Friday, she has Friendly Fridays where she hosts a guest blog from someone out there. It's usually writer types promoting their books or what have you, but that's at christinebryant.blogspot.com. Thanks so much for visiting us today at Ask Allie. If you would like to have your question answered on one of my episodes, leave your question in the comment trail or email allie@alliecross.com. Next week, I'll answer Daisy Whitney's question. If I could be any fictional character, who would that be? The thing is, I don't even know the answer myself. I'm going to have to seriously think about this. Okay, so come on back next week for another edition of Ask Ali. Thanks again for visiting today, and don't forget to visit Christine's blog. See you all next week. Bye, everybody.